Matthew 22, verse 14. From the above portion, we can conclude that the portion can be divided into two parts. The first parable can be said that in the first half of this parable, a king prepared a wedding feast and invited many people to the feast. When the day of the feast arrived, the king sent out his servants to remind those whom he had invited that the day had come. In this case, all the guests decided to stay away and provided their token excuses. Also, many of them seized the servant of the king to beat them and kill them, which was a direct affront to honor. So the king sent out his servant again to find anybody he could attend the wedding feast. They gathered whomever they found, both good and bad, and brought them to participate in the joy of the king. The first part of the parable is primarily about how Israel, as God's chosen people, had been invited to participate in the party that accompanied the arrival of the Messiah. But when Jesus arrived, most of those in Israel wanted nothing to do with Jesus. So they invited the sinners, tax collectors and prostitutes instead. The chief priests and Pharisees obviously did not like hearing the short messages that Jesus told around them. So they thought about to arrest and kill him. The second half of the parable, which is almost a separate parable of itself. It is about a man who shows up at the feast without the proper wedding attire, that means the wedding clothing. The king asks how the man got into the wedding without the proper clothing. And when the man is unable to answer, the king has him thrown out of the wedding hall and into the darkness outside. This is strange to modern wearers. For what else could the king expect from the people he had rounded up from the streets and back valleys? Why would a homeless man have proper wedding attire? The answer is that in such situations of the mandatory culture, the king would make sure to provide proper wedding clothes to all the guests as they arrive. So the king's question to the improperly dressed man is not so much, why aren't you wearing the right clothes, but rather, how did you get in here? If you had come in by the front gate, you would have been the proper clothing. In fact, that you are wearing improper clothing includes that you came in by some other way. This is the remnant statement Jesus earlier told, that only thieves and robberies enter the sheepfold by coming over a wall, in John 10:1. Everyone else come in through the front gate. The man who was in the feast without the proper clothing was a thief who climbed in over the wall. Most uncommonly, of course, is that there were likely many thieves in the wedding feast, but they had come in through the front door and so they were properly wedding entry. Many are invited to participate in the feast, but only those who showed up and came through the front door got to join the celebration. This sort of statement would have been offensive to many Jews at that time, for they considered themselves to be the God's only chosen people. Jesus is not denying their chosenness, but is saying that if they do not live up to the reason they were chosen by God, which is to serve others and to be a blessing to the world, then God will simply choose others such as the prostitutes, thieves and cultures. And if it is argued that they are not worthy, that they are not clothed in righteousness, Jesus says, don't worry, they will be given the proper clothing as they enter into the wedding hall. Jesus is saying that while many people were called to participate in his kingdom, only those who shows up are chosen to join in the festival. But you have to come in the right way, which is through the front door, for only in this way will the guest of properly clothed to live, serve and function within kingdom of God. All are invited and it does not matter who shows up first or last. All will be welcome. Those who accept the invitation, however, must recognize that while they will be given blessings and benefits from the abundance of God's generosity, these blessings and benefits must be gained the right way and must be used in the service of others. Hence, the conclusion from this passage is that in this Lent period, everyone has got their own blessings and ability to do certain things. So use that ability as the blessing which is given by our God Almighty for the betterment of others, to help others, to guide others, and to serve others. Thank you.